Hello friends, welcome to my channel Skill on Tech. In this video, we shall learn about how to do hydro test of power plant, process plant and cross-country metallic pipelines. As you know, without pipes, no plant can exist. Freshers and engineering students of mechanical branch must know about hydrostatic test of pipelines. Video become very interesting, hence please see the complete video. If you like this video, please subscribe to our channel and share video with your friends and colleagues. Code to be followed for hydro test of industrial piping. You can see a picture of process plant piping in the slide. Following codes prescribe requirement for the design, material, fabrication, erection, test and inspection of piping system. So what are these codes? ASME B 31.1. This code is used for power plant piping. ASME B 31.3. Code is used for process plant piping. ASME B 31.4. Code is used for liquid petroleum transportation piping system. ASME B 31.5. Code is used for refrigeration piping. ASME B 31.8. Code is used for gas transmission and distribution piping system. You can see a picture where hydrostatic test of a pipeline is conducted. So how hydrostatic test pressure as per code? Let us know. Design temperature should be always greater than test temperature. ST upon S must be less than 6.5. PT equal to test pressure 1.5 P ST upon S. So what is this? ST equal to allowable stress at test temperature PSI. S allowable stress at design temperature PSI. PT minimum hydrostatic test pressure PSI G gauge. P internal design pressure PSI G. So these are the terms used for calculation of a hydrostatic test pressure. What is the terminology pressure used for hydrostatic test as per code? Design pressure. The pressure for which pipeline is designed considering maximum sustained operating pressure MSOP within the piping system including the effect of static head and designed for the maximum differential pressure anticipated during operating, shutdown or test conditions. Minimum test pressure. What is minimum test pressure? During pressure test performed in accordance, the circumferential hoop stress shall not exceed 90% of the yield strength at 2% offset at test temperature. In addition, the sum of longitudinal stresses due to test pressure and live and dead loads at the time of test, excluding occasional loads, shall not exceed 90% of the yield strength at test temperature. This strength is of material. Terminology: temperature as per code, design temperature, pipe metal temperature representing the maximum sustained condition of temperature expected during operation. Test temperature, the temperature of test liquid during hydro test of pipeline. You can see some pictures of CS studs A193 grade B7M of alloy steel and spiral wound gaskets. Arrangement for hydro test is very important. If arrangement for hydro test is not done properly as per approved procedure, then complete hydro test procedure can fail and we have to repeat the exercise again. So what are the guidelines to be followed are mentioned here. Follow approved procedure for hydro test. All safety precautions shall be taken during hydro test as per job hazard analysis. Use standard blinds, flanges and pipe spools in place of wall if excluded. Adequate size and rating of gaskets, blind flanges, fasteners shall be used during hydro test similar to design requirement of pipeline. Temporary supports, blinds, spool pieces and other preparatory items shall be in place. Hydro test stops, piping supports and spring hangers shall remain in place during the hydro test. Test fluid and hydro test pump are very important for hydrostatic test of pipeline. We must take appropriate care while selecting both. So what is the criteria of selection of a test fluid and hydro test pump? You can see a picture of a hydro test pump which is shown. Liquid medium water is the preferred pressure test medium. A hydrostatic test requires hydro test pump of suitable pressure test range with calibrated pressure gauge. Water quality shall abide by the following standards. Total suspended solids should be less than 100 ppm. Total dissolved solids TDS shall be less than or equal to 2000 ppm. pH of water shall be between 7 to 9. Chlorine content shall be less than 50 ppm. This is very important while carrying out hydrostatic test of stainless steel pipelines. The preferred water temperature range is between 16 degree centigrade to 38 degree centigrade. How to follow test procedure and what may be the hydrostatic test time? This is very important. A picture of a pressure gauge conducting a hydro test is shown where a pressure gauge is showing some pressure readings. What is the pressure in the pipeline? Another picture of a time clock is shown which will tell you what may be the time for retaining pressure, test pressure in the pipeline during conducting a hydro test of the pipelines. The pressurization shall be gradual and steady manner. This is very important. We have not to pressurize the pipeline immediately with the full test pressure. So initial pressurization shall be done up to 110% of the specified minimum yield strength and held for 10 minutes. Hydrostatic test pressure at any point in the piping system shall not be less than 1.5 times the design pressure. And we have to carry out the check of leakages. Pressurization minimum time is 10 minutes and may then be reduced to the design pressure and held for such time as may be necessary to conduct the examination for leakage. After bringing down the test pressure to design pressure, we have to carry out the survey of entire pipeline and check the joint tightness and leakages if any observed in the piping system. Pneumatic test if required shall be conducted at 1.1 to 1.2 times of design pressure in steps of 10% test pressure. During pressurization, maintain continuous surveillance for leak on test equipments, connections, flanges, etc. Depressurize when making repairs to pipe segment or equipment or when tightening bolts. After successful hydro test, pipeline shall be depressurized. After successful hydro test, post hydro test requirements are to be carried out. A picture is shown of pipeline where terminal end is blinded for hydro test. What are these requirements? Draining of test fluid, the pressure shall be released and the system shall be drained. All vents shall be opened before draining to facilitate drainage and to prevent the formation of a vacuum in pipeline. No test fluid shall remain in low points. If possible, pigging operations propelled by compressed air should be used to dewater and dry the pipeline. Consideration should be made for water disposal when chemicals, biocides, inhibitors, or dyes are introduced to the test medium. Blinds and spectacle blinds shall be removed. Temporary test vents and drains used for hydro test shall be removed and the connections permanently sealed. All temporary items installed for testing purpose, such as manifolds, walls, blinds, spacers and supports, shall be removed. All the connections removed for testing shall be restored. After successful completion of hydro test, documentation shall be done. So, what is that final documentation? A pressure test record form can be used to document the pressure testing and can become part of the final pressure test report. An explanation of all pressure discontinuities, including test failures, appearing on the pressures recording charts shall also be included. The report shall contain the temperature and pressure recording charts from the test. These charts shall be signed by the testing company and an owner representative. These signatures verify that the charts were produced by the recorder during the hydrostatic test pressure and conducting a pressure test of the pipeline. That is all for this video. Thank you for watching this video. If you like it, please hit the like button below and share with your friends and colleagues. Please leave your questions, comments, and feedback in section below. Thank you.